Hi there, I'm Vincent Boss and I provide dating and self-improvement advice. And in today's podcast, we're going to be discussing dumper insecure. So before we get into the podcast, I just want to let you know about my website, dateme.tips. That's www.dateme.tips. Do you need help trying to save your crumbling relationship? Would you like advice on how to try and get your ex back? Or maybe you need an action plan on how to try and get a girlfriend or boyfriend. I provide email coaching on all of these subjects and can help your specific situation. Visit my website dateme.tips to find out more details. That's www.dateme.tips. You will also find on my site the books that I've written, my clothing range and other information. Please check your spam and junk folders if you are expecting an email from me. So now let's get back into today's podcast, and today we are discussing dumper insecure. So if you've been dumped and you want to try to get your ex back, it is natural to be wondering what your ex is feeling. As they are the dumper and as they have made the decision to end the relationship, you are likely thinking that they are feeling very secure with themselves and they are of higher value. Now, even if you're not thinking that consciously, certainly subconsciously, it is a natural feeling to feel lower value to your ex who has made a decision that has ended the relationship because you didn't want it to end. They've made the decision, and what they wanted was the decision that happened. So because of that, there's a subconscious feeling that your feelings don't matter because they're of higher value. And the problem is that a lot of dumpees start to reaffirm this security, to start reaffirming this value into their ex, into the dumper. And they do this by begging, by pleading, by trying to reason with their ex. And all this is doing is subconsciously saying to their ex, saying to the dumper, you're better than me. I can't live my life without you. I'm not a full person without you in my life. Please come back to me. Just help me out. Please, please, please. And that is just going to reaffirm, give the dumper all of the security they need in their decision that they are of higher value. And I'm here to tell you today that if you want to try to get your ex back, if you want to get a dumper to change their mind, you need to make the dumper feel insecure with their decision. And this is what today's podcast is going to be about. It's going to be giving you advice about how you can try to make your ex go from feeling secure with their decision to insecure with their decision. At this point, I just want to mention my weekly wingman service. I can be your wingman for the week, providing you with bespoke motivational encouragement. This can be to help with your love life, as well as help ingrain a self-improvement mindset. The course begins with an audio call for us to speak, and then moves on to emails. For more details on this service, please click the link in the description. So if you are trying to get your ex back, if you want to make a dumper change their mind, you need to move them from feeling secure in their decision to insecure in their decision. And the way you do this is to not reaffirm their decision, is to not make them feel like they've made the correct choice. And that is because subconsciously your ex will be expecting you to beg, to plead, to reason with them. So first of all, if you don't do that, then you are straight away pulling the rug from under them and saying, okay, you know, you made that decision. I'm not really happy about it. You know, I want to be in a relationship with you. I don't want this to end. But if you're going to say this, then I respect your decision. And if you ever want to talk again, just get in touch. If you can say something like that, if you can stay emotionally stable, then this is going to start to make your ex wonder about you straight away. Because initially, they are going to be expecting you to beg and to plead. And they don't really want this. You know, on the surface, they don't want this because it can feel very irritating. But subconsciously, it will reaffirm they made the correct decision. So if you're very reasonable, if you're very emotionally controlled at this point, then you are going to straight away confuse their subconscious and for them to start wondering, okay, well, I didn't expect them to do that. Okay, so then at this stage, you might be thinking, what do I do next? Well, secondly, you need to go through self-improvement. You need to make sure you are a better person today than you were yesterday and a better person tomorrow than you are today. And you do this from various angles. You want to make sure you're looking at all aspects of your life, health and fitness, education, skill set, emotions. All of these things can be improved upon, you know, and you might want to be considering doing some work on yourself, whereas this is might be exercise, or maybe you go to see a counsellor to work on your emotions. This could be that type of stuff where it's very kind of solitary. Or, as I would suggest, you would go to join a club, a group or a class, because this will fit in nicely with the next element. So you're going through self-improvement, but if you can do that whilst mixing with new people, you are really going to start making your ex wonder about you. Because firstly, you have been very respectful, you've respected their decision, you've kept emotional self-control. Secondly, you're going through self-improvement, which is showcasing that you don't need them to be a better person. You don't need them in your life to push forward, because you're not just going to crumble without them. And thirdly, if you're doing this with other people, if you're joining new classes, groups and clubs, then you're mixing with new people. And if you mix with them, you are likely to start to make new friends, new acquaintances, and even possible new love interests. All of these things are likely to slowly drip feedback to your ex through friends of friends, through social media. All of these type of things will let your ex know that you are moving on with your life, you are going forward, you're not looking backwards, and you are quite happy without them. And this is where it really starts to pull on your ex's security feelings, because all of a sudden, everything they thought about you and everything they expected hasn't happened. They thought that you was going to beg and plead. They thought that you would fall apart without them. And even though they no doubt, they, you know, they didn't want you to be very low. They didn't want you to be depressed. They didn't want you to be really just standing still in your life without them. They didn't want this. However, they expected this subconsciously. And once you change that, once you don't behave how they actually expect, all of a sudden, that is going to start to make them feel slightly insecure about their decision. Now, the next element is just something that you can't really do other than wait, and that is time. Because a dumper will only start to feel insecure about everything they've done once they've realised the grass isn't greener. Now, I must add, there is no 100% guaranteed way to get your ex back. There is no magic spell, okay? And in some instances, you will never hear from your ex again, okay? In some instances, your ex will meet somebody new and it will be brilliant straight from the off. But these instances are rare. In most situations, your ex will likely meet somebody who will be a rebound relationship. They will be a connection which doesn't last very long, probably a few months at the most. This is the point where they are really going to start questioning themselves, because if they are realizing that you're not begging them, you're not pleading, and they've heard on the grapevine that you're mixing with new people, you're joining new classes, you're improving yourself, you're looking better in your photos, you seem like you're having a great time, you're more knowledgeable, you've started a business, maybe you've got a new job, maybe you've learned how to drive, all of these types of things. If they're noticing that you're improving yourself, you're mixing with new people, there's photos of you on social media at parties having a great time, and at the same moment, they're looking at their own life, and in their life, it's not really that great. You know, they've had this relationship, it was a rebound, it wasn't brilliant. All of a sudden, they're going to be thinking, well, have I made the right decision? Because, you know, I've dumped my ex and they didn't seem bothered. And not only that, they've really grown without me. You know, they've become a better person without me. And I'm looking at social media and I'm hearing from my friends. They're mixing with new people. Other new people want to spend time with them. So they can't be that bad a person. And then on the same hand, they're looking at their own life and they're realizing, well, you know, what's happened to me? I've got into this relationship. It wasn't very good. And now I'm single again. I'm single. I'm lonely. And they look really popular. And at this moment, if you've done everything right, you stand a fantastic chance of your ex reaching out to you, okay? If you haven't done all of the first elements I've told you about, then there is less chance of your ex deciding to reach out to you, because all of this needs to come together in like a perfect storm, as they say. Once your ex has that rebound, once they realise it's not worked, once they're feeling lonely, okay, if they then think you're a better person than they remembered, they will then reach out. However, if you beg and plead, if you don't do anything with your life, if you don't become a better person, then once your ex has this rebound, they're not really going to think much. You know, they're just going to think, well, okay, that rebound didn't work out. I remember my ex, you know, they haven't done anything since. You know, I was right. I was right just to leave them. I was right to end the relationship, because all they've done is they've annoyed me with begging and pleading text messages, and seemingly they're just not doing anything with their life. You know, they're just stagnant. That's not very attractive. And they'll move on to find somebody else. Okay. You know, and that is really going to hinder your chances of getting your ex back. As I said, there's no 100% guaranteed way that anything will work. Sometimes your ex will meet somebody and it won't be a rebound, okay? And if they meet somebody after an initial rebound, there's more likelihood that that will last longer. That is just how things are. But to give yourself the best possible chance, you need to make your ex feel insecure with their decision. And you do that by becoming a better version of yourself. You do that by showcasing it to new people, and this will drip feedback to your ex. And then if this combines at the exact right moment where your ex is feeling a little lonely after a possible rebound hasn't gone right, that is when they will reach out to you. So I hope you've enjoyed today's podcast. I hope this has given you some hints and tips and advice of what you can try to do to get your ex back if that is what you want. Be a better person, okay? Always stay emotionally controlled. Try to be somebody who others want to spend time with. And if it's not your ex, then somebody else will want to be that person. With or without your ex, you will have a positive future. Yeah, if you miss your ex, we can help with that. Help you get him back, or we can help find you someone else. Yeah, yeah, Vincent Bo, the relationship coach, giving you some insight, bringing you a new approach. DateMe.tips, go and check the site, giving you advice, helping with your love life. Get your ex back, or move to the next, ain't no sweat. You know Vincent Bo got you, finding love ain't no problem. Yeah, DateMe.tips, check it out now.